as we know, you cannot be literate if you are not having access to the right materials. And that's why today we are witnessing this handover or this handover ceremony of the books to the Ministry of Education, but going to specific schools where World Vision works. In this consignment, we have about 1,800 thematic curriculum charts for P1. We have 500 Southern P1 math and English practice books. We also have about 50 Southern P2 math and English practice books for children, but also we have 60 Southern books for P4 for mathematics and English and social studies. We also have 1,200 blackboard geometry sets, which according to the needs assessment we did, there are materials which are lacking in our schools today. These materials will benefit about 160,000 children in about 634 schools in the 10 districts of Chiwale, Bulisa, Ofaka, Bundibujo, Nakasongola, Padei, Putaleja, Gulu, Busia, and Tororo. World Vision, this year we are celebrating 30 years in Uganda. We started in 1986. Therefore, having a function like this one also is part and parcel of our celebrations of 30 years here in Uganda. We have decided that buying in single sourcing doesn't help us much in value for money. Therefore, we have gone in bulk buying, and that's why we have all the books going to the schools at this particular time. And the plan is that we will keep on going into the other school and other classes, P5, P6, and P7, because in our current strategy, our main focus is on preschool and primary school. And again, these books have costed at about 1.2 billion shillings. Mainly, they'll go into, I would say all of them, they'll go into UPE schools. And it's our commitment that we ensure that we work with the teachers that they're able to effectively engage with the children, but also the school management committees, to ensure that the children are able to read even after school hours.
A call to the head teachers and the teachers of the beneficiary schools, the 624 schools. Head teachers and teachers in those schools, we have a list, and I'll definitely personally will make a passionate appeal to them and even deliberate visits to these schools to ensure that these books are put to good use. The books should be put to the best use. The books should be taken care of, and the books should be used to the extent that we can see children benefit more from those other children who may not have the opportunity of touching these books. Understandable that the books look so nice. They are really beautiful. They are beautiful, they are durable, and so on. But it is not enough for a head teacher or teacher to say the books are too good to be touched by the children. However good, beautiful they look, they are for the children. Let the children touch them, let the children use them, let the children darten them if it happens. But it is upon the teachers and head teachers to ensure that the books are well utilized and well kept. And in case a page or two gets torn, it's upon the teachers and head teachers to lend a hand and make sure the books are mended or repaired so that they can last a longer period. I'm also happy that all these books and materials are according to the national curriculum. The national curriculum that was approved by the National Curriculum Development Center has been followed strictly in the purchase of these materials. That means all materials can be put to the best use in our schools without any excuse by the head teachers and the teachers.